Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Developer Advocate. With the US holiday last week, we didn't have an episode, so this week's episode comprises of two-ish weeks of dev news. It is the dog days of summer, but that doesn't mean there's not a lot of cool stuff happening. First, in what might be the first ever instance of breaking news in the history of TWC9, I literally added this about 5 minutes before we recorded, we have true breaking news. Guido van Rossum, the creator and BDFL of Python, that's the benevolent dictator for life, he has announced that he is leaving his role as BDFL of the project. Guido isn't choosing a successor and is leaving it up to the Python community. I don't have a lot to say about this yet and what it'll ultimately mean for the language and the community, but I would like to thank Guido for creating Python and guiding it so well over the last 27 years. Next up, in rare hardware news on TWC9, Microsoft announced the Surface Go earlier this week, a 10-inch baby Surface that I have no need for yet want desperately. Starting at just $399, the Surface keyboard and Surface pin are sold separately, so it's really like more like starts at $499. This is a two-in-one for developers, students, or anyone who wants a lightweight and portable Windows 10 machine that can fit in a large purse with ease. Like I said, I don't have any real need for one of these slick devices, but man, do I want one. If only so I can play around with VS Code in Coach on an airplane without feeling cramped, and then flick over to Netflix to watch season 2 of Glow like a boss. You can pre-order the Surface Go now, and it hits stores on August 2nd. Next up, the June update for VS Code hit and VS Code 1.2.5 has some amazing new features. As always, our pal Brian Clark made a release notes video that you can view in full in the show notes, but a few of my favorite features include the new grid editor layout, which lets you customize horizontal and vertical editor layouts, and the new portable mode, which makes it easy to run or copy your VS Code setup from a thumb drive or a file share. And you've got to enable this mode in Windows, Linux, or Mac OS for it to work the way you want it to. And I've linked to that docs page in the show notes. There are some excellent VS Code syncing extensions available, but a fully-fledged portable mode with all of your own stuff is super, super cool. There are lots of other features too, so check it out in the show notes for a full list. Back at Build 2018, the .NET team released ML.NET 0.1, a cross-platform open-source machine learning framework for .NET developers. And this week, the team has released a new version, ML.NET 0.3, which adds support for exporting models to the ONNX format. It enables creating new types of models with factorization machines, like GBM ensembles and like DA, and it addresses a variety of issues and feedback received from the community. The export to ONNX format is a big deal because that's the open standards format for deep learning backed by Microsoft, Facebook, AWS, NVIDIA, Intel, AMD, and others. And if you're looking to get started with ML.NET, sample apps are in the GitHub, and I've linked to the blog post announcing this release and to the GitHub repo in the show notes. On Channel 9 this week, we've got lots of great content. Over on Five Things, John Papa is joined by Brandy Morgan to learn 5 things about React components, so be sure to check that out. Over on Gals, I interview my friend, the amazing Paige Bailey. She's a CDA focusing on machine learning and AI at Microsoft, and she's the best, and I really loved hearing about her story and how she got into tech, so please check that out. And over on the Open Source Show, Chloe Condren from Sentry.io joins CDA Jessica Dean to talk about how to do open source meetups, both from the perspective of being a host or presenter and as an attendee. And now it's time for Bruno's Java Corner, where I share some Java news shared to me by Bruno Borges, our Java CDA team lead. First up is the news that the Spring Starter for Azure Active Directory is now integrated with Spring Security 5.0. And this makes it really easy to build OAuth 2.0 authentication and authorization flows into your Java apps in the cloud. Check out the blog post in the show notes for how to get started. Next, there's a new feature in the Maven plugin for Azure App Service. And this is a plugin that seamlessly integrates Azure services into Maven projects. And now you can deploy your WAR file to Azure Web Services, to Azure Web Apps rather, on Linux using the built-in running stack of Java 9 and Tomcat 8.5 or 9.0. And check out the show notes for a link to the blog with more details. And finally, it's time for a shout out to Jonathan Giles, who was just named a Java champion. Congrats, Jonathan. In some very cool Azure news, static website hosting for Azure Storage is now in public preview. This is a feature we've heard requested from so many people in the community, and I'm happy to see that this is in preview. The feature set is available in all public cloud regions, and support for government and sovereign clouds is coming soon. And if you're like me and you're constantly looking at static site generators and have found the process of deploying those sites to Azure less than ideal, this is for you. So check out the link in the show notes for getting started and some documentation on what you need to know. And now it's time for my pick of the week. And since we missed last week and this is my show, I've decided to do two picks. First up is something I saw last week on Hacker News, proving that Hacker News occasionally can be more than just circular arguments and pedantry. I'm kidding. I love you, Hacker News. Never change. Anyway, the website is called Excel Unusual, and it shows off the most unusual and amazing Excel spreadsheets. Frequent viewers of my hosting era of this program will note that I really like weird use cases of Excel because, honestly, it makes me happy to see people use tools this way. But even if you're typically not impressed by Excel art, check out the website because some of the examples are absolutely bananas. My second pick of the week is from MIT with a hat tip to my friend and former colleague Andrew Lazuski over at Gizmodo, and a new AI project from MIT's Computer Science and Artificial Intelligence Laboratory basically created an app that can look at video material of musical performances and isolate sounds based on the specific instruments and make them louder or softer. And you've got to see the video, which is linked in the show notes, for all the details. But this is really, really cool. And in fact, I really can't wait for this sort of technology to get integrated into video and audio editing programs in the future. The future is so cool. Well, that's it for me. Let me know your favorite static site generator in the comments. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you can get updated every time we publish great new content. And I'll see you next week.